No, I think markets will continue to remain, range bound for the simple reason, that now macro headwinds are getting more challenging. With the rupee now getting weaker, I think clearly markets are little worried. That is probably the reason why we saw good amount of action both on the IT and the pharma sectors today. In fact, that will continue to be the kind of positive tailwind for both these sectors. But if you look at maybe the metal sector, I think because of the U.S.-China kind of trade negotiation, I think today, the market was expecting that the metal sector will correct, and that is exactly what happened. So my sense is, I think the metals sector will definitely continue to drag the index, and I think broadly it's going to be a stock-specific index, because the markets are going to find a very strong resistance around, say, 10,890-odd level. So whenever we have that kind of level coming, we probably see some sort of resistance and profit booking. In today's market, it was very clearly visible that, because of the softening in the crude oil prices, I think some amount of bounce, ahead of the OPEC meet, I think oil prices have corrected. So that is going to be a kind of a sentiment driver, at least in the near term. If oil prices do correct, at least after the OPEC meet on 22nd, then probably you'll see a little bit of sentiment, getting better. But overall, I would say that the markets are going to remain in a very narrow range, and you're going to see specific sectors and stocks, only outperforming, maybe IT, pharma, or maybe oil marketing companies. But overall, I think it's going to be very, very limited. It's not going to be a very broad-based, rally on the index. You'll find a lot of action, stock-specific. See, I think global equities are worried that, probably now U.S. has announced a lot of restrictions for China. Maybe China will also impose a lot of restrictions for global companies which operate there. So, that will actually, signal a war basically for a lot of other emerging markets, because clearly China is a very big trading partner with not only U.S. but a lot of other, emerging kind of countries.
Yes.
So my sense is, if this trade war continues, and if this accelerates further, then probably you're going to see Indian exports also to that extent, getting corrected, because as it is, we may not be very large exporters to U.S. But within the Asian bloc and other emerging countries, we obviously, every country will start thinking about their, trading kind of surplus or deficit, and accordingly, will be imposing restrictions. So I think probably in that sense, the market is little worried that, what Trump is doing for U.S. can get repeated by every country, and that is not a good sign. So that is what the overall picture is. But at least U.S., China, whatever happens, it has some implications on all the emerging markets, because whether we like it or not, these are very large trading partners, so it will obviously affect the broad, global sentiment. Yeah, I think clearly, we would be, we are at least telling our clients that wherever, you've got large exporting companies, you've got exposure to the dollar, I think those companies will benefit the most, because now it's a very clear indicator that, the dollar is getting stronger, and economy in the U.S. is also getting stronger. So obviously, you will have a stronger dollar. And that will mean a weaker rupee. So I think, you're going to see a lot of traction in most of these pharma companies, IT companies, maybe auto component companies. Specifically, if you were to ask me, stocks like Bharat Forge, or typically, even IT companies, obviously they have large, dollar exposure, and some part of the dollar, appreciation and the rupee weakening will obviously aid their margin. So clearly, I think, investors should actually now start looking at these export-oriented companies slowly, because we could see levels of 69.5, those kind of levels approaching. So that time it will benefit these companies.